ClickUp for content creation. There's a lot of ways we can set up ClickUp to help you create content and be better at creating content. But that also means there's a lot of ways you might be setting ClickUp up for content creation that are just not as efficient. Hi, everybody. I'm Yvonne Hyman with AskEvie.com, and I am a business efficiency consultant for digital entrepreneurs. And if you are ready to automate, streamline, and organize your digital business, then go hit the subscribe button because we are talking efficiency today. Now, if you have watched some of my old videos, you know that I've been preaching, especially when it comes to social media content creation, to use an advanced social media scheduling tool rather than doing the whole building the content in ClickUp and then copying and pasting it over and doing all the things, simply because ClickUp wasn't there yet. I'm sorry, there was no efficient way to build social media content in ClickUp. Now, I'm retracting that. ClickUp had brought out in the past the capability and the feature within ClickUp to use the custom due date, the custom date field in the calendar view, in all other things, and in more other things. So since then, we've been reorganizing, restructuring, and testing content creation workflow in ClickUp. You're gonna get to see more of that in upcoming videos. But first though, I wanna talk about the five mistakes that I have seen people do when using ClickUp for content creation. So let's head on over to my ClickUp and I'll show you what I'm talking about. Mistake number one, you might have heard that one before. Do not just drop your ideas into ClickUp as a task. Please don't. We are starting with ideas in actually a document. No matter if you are handling it straight through the documents, no matter if you are adding it as a view up here as a document, no matter if you were even using water notes in your shower, if you have a notebook next to your bed, if you are using your phone, whatever it is, and we'll come to more of that in just a second, start with a notepad. Start noting things down because you first need to actually validate your ideas. The moment your idea is validated and you're like, yep, that's what we're gonna go with, keywords fine, everything awesome, that's when it becomes an actual task. Now, if you're like me and you have notepads and sticky notes and everything all over the place because literally ideas strike in the weirdest moments, which means I need to have notebooks all over the place, make sure you add your idea collection as a task in your daily method of operation, or at least once a week, where you have a task that recurs automatically to remind you, hey, by the way, Evie, did you grab those awesome ideas you had in the shower? What about those ones that come right in the morning when you're still half asleep and you gotta write it down just so you don't forget it? Make it a recurring task so you don't lose those ideas and they're just sitting there. We always wanna take action of everything. So once you got them in your idea dump and you went through a tool like TubeBuddy to validate those ideas, to start figuring out your keywords, to start figuring out your title, and you know this is a topic you want to talk about, that is when it actually goes as a task into your list and under ideas. Cool. Let's go on right ahead to mistake number two. Now, I went ahead and actually set this up in here for you so you see what I'm talking about. I have seen a lot of people set up lists for their content of Q1, Q2, Q3, and Q4. No matter if that is a working base or, hey, I just want to get back and use this as an archive. This is not a good way to handle your content creation in here. Because the moment you manually move something into that list and say it happened or will happen in Q4, it's a graveyard. You are never going to get back to this content. You're never going to check it out again. You're never going to do anything else with it the moment it's posted. So it's not even an archive. Don't do that. As you can see, the structure we are working with right now is the platform, in this case, YouTube, ideas in the works and then published. So rather than building graveyard lists like those Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4, make use of your filters. Make use of your custom filtered lists. I'm going to show you exactly what I mean by that. Looking at this list, we have usually two due dates. We have an actual task due date, and I'll come to that here in just a second, as well as a YouTube publish date. So wanting to show your content by Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4. And by the way, which quarter are we talking about? 2020, 2021, maybe even back to 1990s? Which Q2, 3, 4 are we talking about here? I always gotta make a joke about it. With this, you easily can go into your list or your board view, do the filter. Now the question is, which due date are we going for? In this case, I really want to sort out my YouTube videos by the YouTube publish date. So rather than sorting those by the due dates, we are sorting those by the YouTube publish date. And that is, let's scroll down, where is it? Last quarter, this quarter, next quarter. This is how easy you can build interactive and easily automatically adjustable lists. It's not a fixed thing. It always grows with you. Once we are in 2023, I don't want to see Q4 2021 content. So do this rather, because it stays up to date. It saves you a bunch of manual work and it's just there. Now, if you are using this as an archive and you specifically want content from, I don't know, Q4 2020, you still can do a custom time frame. There we go, date range. And then we can choose a specific date range. Again, don't hide your content just somewhere in a list. Make it interactive, make it usable, make it less manual with filters and custom list views. Now, mistake number three comes right after this, because I already hinted on it, due dates. And that was one of the big features that finally allowed me to use ClickUp as a content creation tool. There's a lot of things going on. As you can see, we got YouTube, we got the blog, we got social media, we got a content archive. All of this is coming up on the channel. So if you really want to step up your content creation game in ClickUp, make sure to subscribe and give it a thumbs up so YouTube knows you like this video and you want to see more. Having said this, ClickUp allows you to use a date custom field, which will show in the calendar, which is usable just like anything else. Now, what I have seen is people use that due date, the actual task due date, as the trigger and as the, hey, this is when it needs to get published. And the problem is that doesn't work in a workflow. Your due date on the actual task needs to be when this task needs to be done. So on what day does the content need to be ready? The video has to be recorded, edited, and uploaded. The graphics have to be done, the transcription, the initial promo, the launch promo, all the things. When does this task have to be done? That's your due date. Now, to be able to let your team know when what needs to get published and how and where and why and when, that is when we bring in a custom date field. I always want to call it custom due date. It's not actually a due date, it's just a date. And the nice thing is you can set your calendar to only show those. So no matter how you actually handle your workflow, if you are setting those custom fields up and you are using them as I told you, you can go into your calendar view up in your settings and you go by date custom field and you choose your publishing dates and they will show in here and you have a nice and clean content calendar. Now, let's head back to the list view, because we are coming around. If you've been on my channel, you know this one way too well. Status versus stages. I've seen this a lot happening, especially with content creation, simply because we want to see what's happening. So it's like, yeah, to do in progress, great, Evie, those are your statuses, but I don't need that. I need to know where my stuff is. Or what I have seen are, for example, people that like to see their content Monday through Friday in a setup like this. Cool, we can do that. But if it's Monday through Friday, you don't know, is your team working on it? Is it not working on it? What's happening? Where are we at? It just tells you when you want your content. So make sure that you stay in my standard statuses, which either way could be the simple one of to do, in progress, and done. In this case right here, when you're working with a bigger team where you need more information, more activity information about your task, is when we are using to do in progress, waiting external, meaning I'm waiting for a contractor, I'm waiting for a client to tell me, yes, we can go ahead with this, no, this needs changes, or we are waiting for the client for us to get the images, things like that. Then waiting internal, meaning our team is responsible right now for this bottleneck. Something in the company needs to be done or made a decision on for us to move forward. The final proof and complete. Those are the standard statuses you should be using in here. Any other data information you would like to see, for example, you would like this board to be Monday through Friday. Cool. Not a problem. Simply add a drop-down field called days of the week, just because I can't spell. And let's do that right there. We got Monday, we got Tuesday. Yes, I cannot spell at all. We can Wednesday, all good. Let's stop the week right there. So you have it in here. You can hide it in here if you don't want to see it in the list view. But where I'm going with this is once you are in board view, rather than doing group by status to know what actively is happening on your task, just group it by custom field and then find your days of the week custom field, and there we go. That's how easy you can build something like this without losing the capabilities of ClickUp and shooting in your own foot. And if you don't know yet what I'm talking about, here's the video status versus stages that dives deeper into it. You can do all of this. Just use custom fields and keep your statuses clean. Last but not least, let's talk task management for our mistake number 5. Let's head on over to one of my tasks. If we go in here, what I have seen a lot of people do as of late, because you can, is adding checklists or tasks list right in here. So with the / checklist, cool. We can do task 2, fine, task 3, task 4, awesome. The problem with that is when you are going back into your list view, you have no idea what's happening in this task. Tasks in the description, checklists in the description do not funnel into anything. It doesn't funnel into workload. It doesn't funnel into any time tracking or any of those. Now let's check out the difference when we do task 2 in here and then say task 3 in here. It doesn't matter if you are doing subtask or checklists. You will be able to see those right in here to know what's going on. So please, those checklists in descriptions really should just be a, do you got this information or something like that, where it doesn't matter if you know it's there or not, because you're gonna lose those really fast if they are not easily visible in the main task. So with this, we got all of the 5 mistakes covered that we have seen and experienced while upgrading our content creation in ClickUp. Have you hit the subscribe button yet? Because videos are coming up. I will walk you exactly through all of our setup. No matter if it's YouTube content creation, turning it into a blog post, handling social media tasks, all of that will be upcoming on my channel. So go hit the subscribe button and go give it a thumbs up that YouTube knows you've liked this video. And I'll see you again next week when we are talking about YouTube content creation in ClickUp.